So today I wanted to talk about debt and how debts get treated in a divorce case. It's definitely a part of life, unfortunately, to acquire some debt as a marriage is going forward. You get student loans, you buy a house, you'd have a mortgage payment, you have a car payment, either a car lease, or you're purchasing a car, or you have credit cards, student loans, whatever it might be. As your marriage goes forward, it's very likely that you'll have debt, especially if you have children, you're gonna take on some kind of debt. And in a divorce case, you have to look at how is that debt gonna be treated and what's gonna happen with these debts as you divide up the assets and divide up everything else through a divorce case. Figuring out how to allocate debt can be tricky. There's really kind of a two-part analysis to it is one way to look at it. Number one, we're looking at whose name is on these debts, because if you have a credit card that's in your name only, or a mortgage that's in both names, whatever it might be, you have to look at that first of all. Because in a divorce, we know that if you're the only one on the credit card, you will ultimately be stuck paying for it, meaning American Express can only come after you to collect the debt. They're not gonna care what a judgment of divorce says between you and your wife. So one thing to look at is whose name is on these debts as you're looking at dividing things up. But then it's also an analysis of what was the debt used for. So credit card, the American Express example, you know, might all be in your name, but maybe it was used all for household purchases. You were buying groceries, you were making ends meet, making purchases. Maybe there were some things you acquired for the house. And even though the debt's in your name, it's really marital property that was purchased with it. It's really marital things that were purchased with it, or household ongoing weekly expenses. If it's what you would call marital debt, things that you've split up between each other, you would definitely want to look at, okay, it's only fair that my wife should pay part of this debt. It should not be just up to me, even though my name is on the debt. We know it's in my name only. However, it's not just my debt. It's something that should be shared, just like assets and just like dividing up bank accounts. So that's an analysis to look at. And then another question becomes, well, am I going to be on the hook for my spouse's debt? Do I have to pay my wife's debt in a divorce case? And that depends on a lot of different factors, but for one example, let's say you're the only one that's working, your wife hasn't worked in years, she stayed home, she's raised the kids. At that point, you can expect you probably will be paying for the debt. You've been paying for everything else. It's no different in a divorce. However, if there are assets, it's reasonable to first look at the assets and look at the debts and balance the two. So if we've got $50,000 equity in a home, we got $20,000 in credit card debt, it's only fair to pay off the credit card debt before we start dividing up the equity in the home. Now, if you and your spouse are both working, that's different. It's reasonable to say you should each be paying your share of the credit card debt, probably half and half. And again, it goes back to what also was the debt used for. So debt in a divorce case can be kind of a complicated subject until you unpack it and really look at what are the separate categories, what do we have? So a good starting point, a good strategy, number one is what do you have? What are we dealing with? We can't divide it up if we don't know what we're looking at. So number one, you'd want to pull your own credit report. Look at what debts you have, what's out there. There may be things you've forgotten about. There may be credit cards that you thought were in your wife's name only. Turns out you're on that card or you're an authorized user and therefore somehow liable. There might be a card that was opened without your knowledge, maybe even done behind your back. You need to be watching for those types of things in a divorce case. So number one is preparation. You got to understand what you have.